Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, friends. Let's talk about interview preparation today and what are the various aspects we need to keep in mind while preparing for an interview. Before the interview, research the potential employer by going to their website or looking to their annual reports or talking to the people working in that organization. Know more about the employer. It's very, very important, and you need to gather the information about the employer, the headquarters of the company, the CEO, the chairman, the market capitalization, its revenue, number of people, and global footprint, and their products and services, their competitors, and so on. Review the job description and be able to match your experience and education with the duties of the position. Have a clear mind about your JDJP, job description, job plan, and tailor-made, customize your resume according to the job description, the position, the requirements of the position that are described in the job description. Prepare a 1 to 2 minute script about yourself and write about you to 1 to 2 minutes. So that in script where you'll be able to speak for one couple of minutes about your own self in order to answer the first question, tell me something about you or introduce about yourself. So note it down and practice it and rehearse it. Make sure you have the appropriate interview attire, and attire in the sense your appearance and your dressing, your grooming, and that's very, very important. They call it power dressing, and that's very critical and important. Your interview attire should reflect your seriousness, reflect professionalism and your interest in the position, and be confident and wear a smile. So whatever the attire and the dress, the best of the dress you wear, the most important that the your dressing won't be complete without wearing a gentle smile. So be confident. If you have confidence, of the battle is won, and if you are confident, of the battle is won, and that's the secret of success. Regarding your attire, for men, possible wear a suit or a necktie is very important. Suit is not visible. You can attend with a wear a necktie. Your belt and shoes should be the same color. Avoid a tie with elaborate patterns or too many colors, and therefore make it simple, and it should match with the color of the shirt. And if the color of the shirt is white or light blue or cream or a light color shirt, and your tie needs to be dark color, red, maroon, or dark blue kind of a tie need to be presented. Black leather shoes with laces is preferable and is important, and your shoe needs to be polished in such a way that you should be able to see your face in your shoe is the categorical expression, which means that you need to please polish the shoe. And head to toe hair should be well groomed, and have a short well groomed hair, and it should be presentable, and your shoe should be polished enough. Tips regarding the attire for women: your suit or a dress is preferable, and the skirts should meet at the knob of the knee or longer. Amount of jewelry should be minimized. For women, the jewelry should be minimal. Probably can wear a chain or a minimal jewelry is preferable. Makeup should be light. Wear a light makeup, and that's very important. Don't go with heavy makeup. Avoid excess perfumes or scented powders. Mild perfume for both men and women is advisable, but not excessive perfume or scented powders. Mild perfume is okay. It is advisable, so that we should be conscious about the body odor, the odor emitted by the body, so that when you are there for about 15-20 minutes in the interview cabin, be conscious about our body odor, and so that to see that your interviewer should feel comfortable, and isn't it very important? So see that about our body odor, and apply a mild perfume and avoid excessive perfume. Start the interview. Be sure to arrive 10 to 15 minutes early to the scheduled time of an interview. It's very important, and be ready and come early, sit, relax, take a deep breath, have a glass of water, and have a positive frame of mind and wait for your turn. 10 to 15 minutes showing up early is much important. Greet the interviewer with a firm handshake. It's very important. Look straight into the eye and shake hands gently but firmly. And very important to shake hands. It will show how confident we are with the whole process in the interview. So, a web-to-web shake hand, in the hold it you know, tightly and gently shake for 3 to 4 times is what actually is the norm. So greet the interview with a firm shake hand. It's very important. Don't give loose shake hand, dead fish shake hand, or don't give only couple of fingers, and that's very, very unprofessional and you know, unwarranted. Give a firm shake hand and look into the eyes and wish and gently shake for 3 to 4 times. Maintain good eye contact, contact and posture. Very important. You know, body language is very critical. We discussed earlier that 55% of communication happens through body language and 28% of our communication happens through voice, meaning our tonality, intonation, pitch and speed, and 7% of the communication happens through through language. So since 55% of your communication, it happens through body language, eye contact, gesture, facial movements, lip movements, smile, nodding, overall appearance, be conscious about it. Make sure you are energetic and enthusiastic. Show good energy and enthusiasm for that whole period of 30 minutes or 1 hour, whatever the interview period is. You know, be good, energetic, enthusiastic, and show interest in the process. And your enthusiasm and energy is a sign of your interest, and that will impress the interviewer, rather your prospective employer. Speak clearly and articulate your to the point. Articulate your views and your answer brisk and to the point. Be clear and don't murmur and don't be so loud enough, and see, maintain a via media paralanguage pitch, tone, intonation, pitch and speed. Remember TIPS, and be brisk and to the point. Standard interview questions, you know, to introduce yourself or tell me about yourself. Would you tell me about yourself? What is a generic question, and so we need to rehearse, and as we discussed, we need to mention, prepare for 1 to 2 minutes of answer for that. And what's your greatest strength and what's your greatest weakness? Where do you see yourself in 5 years from now or 10 years from now? What about this position do you first most appealing? So what is most appealing in this position, in this particular role for you, and why do you think you need to be considered for that? Why do you want to work for our company, and what is the salient features that attracted you to work for our company? Why should we hire you? Why do you think you are most suitable for this particular role, particular position, and why should we hire you? Generic questions, and refer the, our earlier video on top 10 interview questions, really have them with answers, help you a lot. Behavioral based questions could be asked, as prepare thoroughly, you know, answers for these questions. So something like, can you describe the most valuable criticism you have received, and what did you do with it? Have you received any criticism in your life so far, from your parents, from your teachers, from your friends, and how did you take that feedback or criticism, and what did you do with it, and how you improved upon it? Can you tell me about an event that really changed you, and what could be the memorable event in your life? Can you give me an example of a project that required attention to detail and how you handled the details? But to see that, to demonstrate IIFL details, and how did you handle it? What was the project about? Can you tell me about a difficult person with whom you have worked? So that shows that how to handle it, you know, difficult people in the work situation. Can you describe the situation where you have demonstrated leadership and teamwork skills to show and display your confidence that you are a good team player and leader? And you take initiative, and what your professors say about you? If you inquire with your professors, what kind of feedback they offer about you? What's your stress coping mechanism? And you need to work for longer hours, especially during project closure delivery time, and you need to prone to subject to work stress or work heavy work pressures. What is your stress coping mechanism, so that they would like to see that how vulnerable or you are strong related to working for longer hours and working under pressures? What's your stress coping mechanism? Have answers ready for these questions. questions to ask the employer, what kind of training will don't finally they'll ask you a question like, do you have any question for us? Please don't leave the room without asking you a question. Ask one or two intelligent questions revolving around your interest in the company, interest in the learning, and your ambition and knowledge about the company, and so on. You can ask questions like, what kind of training will I receive, sir, once I join the organization? What type of career advancement opportunity, career growth opportunities available for a fresher or an experienced person like me in your organization? What are the emerging technologies are being used in your projects in your company, and see, so that is an opportunity for you to work on the cutting edge emerging technologies. What's your expectation from a fresher like me in your company? And so that you get ready before joining that, and to meet and exceed the expectations. Ask questions that demonstrate your interest in learning, ambition, isn't it? Organizations would love to have a good a people with ambitious people who would like to grow up in the career by contributing positively for the growth of the organization, isn't it? Knowledge of their company, industry, and all need to be demonstrated in the form of your questions. So please ask one or two questions. Need additional tips or practice? And I request you to schedule an appointment with me by emailing at letscracktheinterviews.com. We have this is the email ID, letscracktheinterviews.com. And to set up a one-to-one interview. And I do conduct mock interviews to various students and laterals. You can write a mail to me, and then I can fix an appointment so that I will speak to you for a spend about 30 minutes to 1 hour time with you. Wish you all the best, and hope these pointers will help you in preparing for your interview. God bless, take care, and all the best to your interview.